starting with just concealer, and I'm going to be putting this under my eyes and basically any imperfections I have on my face. So just like my redness on my eyes, my redness on my face, any acne that I may be having, I'm just going to be putting that on my face. Then I'm taking a different concealer and I'm going to be using this to highlight the high points of my face, like my forehead, my nose, my cupid's bow, my chin. And I'm actually right here, I'm covering up some red marks on my face because I went to a football game and I put some face paint on and it like irritated my skin. So now that I have like two little red lines on my cheeks, whatever though. And I'm just going to be taking my beauty blender and I'm going to be blending this out, and I'm speeding it up because it's a very long process. So yeah. Now I'm going to be taking some foundation. You don't have to do this. I just did it for the video, basically. I didn't really need to put on foundation that day, but I was just feeling like it. Then I'm going to be setting my face with just a pressed powder. Now I'm taking my bronzer and I'm just going to be bronzing up my cheekbones and up my forehead a little bit. And I'm just going to be blending this out really well. I'm going to also be blending it down my neck so that there's no harsh lines and it all looks natural. I'm also going to be brushing this down my nose a little bit. And I'm going to be taking the same bronzer and I'm just going to contour with it. And I'm using my contour brush and I'm just blending this out really well too. Now I'm taking on my beauty blender, that same highlighting concealer, and I'm just putting this on my highlighting points once again. And I'm going to be blending it out. And now I'm taking my highlighter and I'm just going to be setting the concealer to highlight my face. And I'm just taking that big fluffy brush once again and blend it out. And now I'm taking my blush and I'm just lightly dabbing this with a stippling brush on my face. Now we're going into eyes. I'm just taking this brown matte shade with this blending brush and I'm just going to be putting this into my crease and blending it out really well. I'm not the best at describing, so it's better if you just watch because I can't really describe all that well, so I guess just watch. Now I'm just taking this cream colored and putting it on my brow bone. And I'm blending it with the brown once again. And I'm just going to be taking this darker brown, mostly focusing it on my outer corner where like the outer V is. And I'm going to be blending this really well into my crease. And now I'm going in with this kind of dark brown, maroonish, kind of dark plum purple kind of color. And I'm just going to be focusing this mostly on my outer corner, my outer V area right around there. And I'm going to be blending it into the crease and blending it really well. This maroonish kind of plummy brown color is going to really give the fall feel to this look, which I think makes it look so pretty. And I love using dark purples for like the fall time. And I'm just taking the exact same color with that same brown and I'm going to be pulling this down onto my outer lower lash line. Again, not the best at describing things, just better if you watch. And I'm taking this champagne-y kind of color and I'm going to be putting this all in my lid and I'm going to be blending it in with the outer corner as well. Sorry if this is confusing anyone, again, not the best at describing. And then I'm putting this kind of pearlescent champagne color, a different color, and I'm putting it in the inner corner and blended it well. So that's the eyeshadow. Now going in with my eyebrows, I want to do a separate video on how I fill in my eyebrows, so I'm just speeding the process along. I know I do my makeup in really weird order and I know I should finish my eyes first, but I'm going in with my eyebrows, so I'm just filling in my eyebrows. As you can see here, and it's going really fast, but again, I wanted to do a separate video on how I filled my eyebrows in. So I'm just spooling them out. And that's my finished eyebrows. And now I'm going in with my liquid eyeliner. And I'm just going to be winging it out. And I do my wing every single day. This is what I do. And I think I want to do a more detailed video on how I do my winged eyeliner as well. But you can kind of see what I'm doing. I'm just kind of making a triangle and I'm filling the triangle in. And yeah, my camera likes to become blurry at some parts. Don't really know why, but it does. So I'm sorry if you see that. And I had to do my other eye off camera because it's weird. I need two hands to do that eye. But for the eye I showed you, I only need one hand to do it. It's really weird, but yeah. And now I'm going in with my falsies that I was so excited to use until I spilled glue on my finger. But hey, I'm still going to use it. I mean, we don't want to waste money here, do we? So I'm just going to be gluing my eyelashes and we're going to wait for them to get tacky, have a little dance party. And I realized there's no way I'm doing this on camera, so I did it off camera. So that's what they looked like. And I thought they looked really good for me being able to do them because I felt like I was going to fail. And now I'm just going to put mascara on the bottom lashes. And I'm taking my handy dandy Q-tip and I'm just going to be wiping away any mistakes that might have occurred. And I'm just going to be putting it also on my real lashes just to help blend them with the falsies so they look more realistic. And that's all the eyes. And now we're going with lips. And I'm taking this dark plum kind of purplish liquid lipstick. And I'm actually not that big of a fan of this one. It dries really weird and I don't really like it, but the color was pretty and I still wanted to use it because I like the color and I can just deal with the texture even though it's really weird. But yeah, and it's not that pigmented, so you might need a few coats of it, but it like dries quickly and it's just really weird. And then on the other end of it, there's like a like oil stick and I think that helps the texture. I don't know, but yeah, I just put that on. And yeah, and I'm doing that trick where you get the lipstick off your teeth thing, and I'm just making sure it looks good. And that's all my makeup, and I took my hair down even though my hair looks ratchet. And yeah,